क्या बोल रहे हो ना? I think after Pakistan, there's not much left for me to say, right?
Yes, sir.
So I'll run through this just to tell you the breadth of what is possible. Then we have a very remarkable woman from Bihar, a woman from Jharkhand, a woman from MP, and then the JNK. So through them, I would like to convey the message of NRLM. I'm just taken a case of Andhra Pradesh because about 20 years of work has gone in here, and when we started the work 20 years ago, I don't think any of us dreamt that this is actually possible. Because we used to think poverty eradication is not possible. But I hope Sajunisa and countless other heroes who convince you that yes, poverty eradication is possible in a finite period of time, and each one of us has a role in that. And as I like what she said, it's not poor don't need charity. Each one of us give us the strength to recognize our own capabilities. Now, when we started the work in 95, they mentioned about UNDP. So there was a UNDP pilot in Andhra Pradesh. This followed from that Independent South Asia Commission recommendations. So after the report was accepted in 1993, UNDP came forward to show a proof of concept in each country, and it was expected that the host country would then scale it up. So the pilot in India was implemented in Andhra Pradesh, and which covered the three districts, Karsol, Anantapur and Mehboob Nagar. And in fact, it has happened indirectly because those women are now taking this movement to the whole country. And in Andhra Pradesh, when we started the program, we recruited young professionals, large number of young professionals. We just had a back of the envelope calculation saying that one young professional for about 2,000 households. We recruited from 2000 to 2004, close to 4,000 people fresh from colleges, postgraduates in social work, rural development. But then we stumbled on to the CRP strategy. After that, we changed our roles. We said the staff of SERP have a facilitation role. The main work will be done by the community resource person. It is through them that we could actually achieve this kind of coverage, that all villages are covered, and about 95% of the rural poor are covered. And so my young colleagues from Andhra Pradesh will get a chance to actually see for themselves and then see what else needs to be done. This is still a work in process. It's not that everything is over. We have another 8 to 10 years of work in Andhra Pradesh to improve the human development indicators, which is now the focus of the program there. And this kind of saturation has also happened in Kerala through the Kudumbashree model, which is another remarkable and a very unique program. And this is the strength, the social capital that we are talking about, is each one trained as a leader. She herself mentioned she was a leader of a central group, the village federation, and the vice president of the Mandal Federation. And there are community professionals, community service providers. Many of the women here, they maintain the books of accounts of the groups. They are health activists, like Sudha is a health activist. Dhanama is a gender activist. So whatever you visualize the essential requirements, so these are the community professionals. And the community resource persons are the community best practitioners. Those whose lives have been transformed are the ones who can make a difference in the newer geographies. And that's a simple philosophy that we adopted. So it can't be too complicated if you have to even visualize that you have to reach out to every village in the country and every poor household in the country. So the model should be so simple and so capable of being done by the people themselves. Only such models will actually make that critical difference of saturation. And this is the federation structure. And these are the three banks that I mentioned. This is actually the first bank. Rajinsa mentioned the support she got from her SHG, the village organization, and the Mandal Samajya in Andhra Pradesh. In other states, it's called cluster federation, and this is called either VLF or a village organization. So we can't think of a better solution than women's own banks. This is a community financial institutions, as contrasted from the microfinance institutions, which are run by for-profit agencies. The bank is an external entity because the interest goes to the bank, whereas here the interest remains within these institutions and contributes to their financial self-reliance. In Jharkhand, for instance, they have kept a 2 rupees as the interest rate, which is also their profit, which is meant for providing for the community service provider. So they are not dependent on government grants for running their institution. So that's very important. And till last year, about 55,000 crores had been mobilized from the banks in Andhra Pradesh. And this year, I think they'll add another 12,000 crores. When we started, it was about 100 crores. This year, they'll touch about 12,000 crores, which would be around 50-55% of the entire country's central group banking. This is very important. As I said, one of our purposes is how do you stabilize their livelihood? And you hear the story from Bihar. It's a fantastic agriculture, sustainable agriculture model that Bihar is, Jivika has initiated. It's winning worldwide acclaim. And this has, it's a very low cost model. Productivity has gone up, incomes have gone up, and Didi from Bihar will explain how they do this. And the similar versions in every state. In Andhra Pradesh, actually we started just with about 200 farmers in 2003-04, and now it covers 30 lakh farmers. And this is again led by the community best practitioners. It's not run by people with degrees in agriculture, postgraduates in agriculture, PhDs in agriculture. So these are people who actually dirtied their hands, soiled their hands, and they achieved remarkable results. And then they go and explain to others. And their credibility is remarkable because when they go and say something, people believe it because they have actually practiced it. So this model, in fact, it's a global best practice. FAO itself has, is in the process of changing their global strategy, and they are seeing our model, with the NRLM or the SERP model, as an answer for many countries. And this is something which is low cost, done by the people themselves, and environmentally very friendly. Well, we also advocate ecologically sustainable agriculture, so zero chemical pesticides, reduce chemical fertilizers, eventually going to zero, and a variety of soil and moisture conservation practices. So this is a real agriculture revolution, I would say, but led by the poor, led by the whom we normally dismiss of as marginal farmers. They are the people who are leading this revolution. Then the women have got into marketing of agriculture produce. They run the procurement centers for paddy. They provide minimum support price to the farmers. And they did about 1400 crores procurement in the 6 to 8 weeks of the paddy season. They run the dairies. There's a program called Jobs for Youth, short-term placement linked skilling, which they are involved in. There's a micro-enterprise development. And there's a fantastic insurance model in Andhra Pradesh, which covers close to 1 crore members and their spouses. And this is also run by the CRPs, there's a call center. So within 24 hours of death in the family members get in touch with the call center, and they get about 5,000 rupees ex gratia immediately within 24 hours. And there's a Bima Mitra, who then processes the, prepares the documents, which are uploaded to the, CRP server, and from there to LIC. So the entire settlement happens between 3 to 4 weeks. The balance 25,000 rupees goes to the legal heirs through this. And it's the world's largest and the least cost insurance model. And this is something which is being replicated in Bihar and also in Tamil Nadu. And there's an amazing health and nutrition initiative, which Sudha will talk about that. This is a very low-cost model, and it is based on what Dr. Arole did in Maharashtra, where he said people's health is in people's hands. It's not that doctors are required for everything. 90% of health is in people's own hands. So how do you transfer that knowledge? How do you make them knowledgeable about health? And it's an amazing initiative on health and nutrition, which those who are interested, you know, we can go deeper into it in the group sessions. There's a gender initiative. I was reminded of that when Tajanisa spoke about the slap she received from her husband. In these days, with Dhanama being present, nobody dares to do that. Their initiatives are amazing. They have solved so many cases, and they have returned close to 27 crores worth of jewelry, land, houses to those members where the differences were irreconcilable, and the police depend on them. Really, I'm not joking. She can ring up the SP Nalgonda anytime, and he responds to her. She was just mentioning in the evening yesterday about a recent case where they ensured that the woman was not killed. And these are extremely heartrending kind of tales, and the kind of courage they have is beyond me. It's remarkable. And there are cases of trafficking which they have stopped, cases of trafficked survivors whom they are, you know, rehabilitating. This is all very difficult thing. It's not easy at all. Then there's a co-contributory pension scheme, and there's an amazing program for persons with disability. So I just took you through some 20 years of work in about 4 or 5 slides. But just to tell you that once you build this institutional platform, there's no end to what kind of issues cannot be tackled by that. And you just saw a sample in Kerala. They are doing the micro enterprises. They are running schools for mentally disabled persons with disabilities. So they, each state is doing its own thing. But first, build the foundation, which is good community institution. So at the national level, we have a national mission. Similarly, states are having their own multidisciplinary teams from the market, from good officers, from the government, who lead these missions, and similar positioning of multidisciplinary people in district and sub-district level. Srimant, who has come from Jharkhand, then Purti from Bihar, Savita ji from Madhya Pradesh. They are all people with a lot of domain experience, and they are at the state level. So it is their job to Lakshmaya from Andhra Pradesh. Saurav supports me at the national level. There are people from the open market, development sector, who have joined these missions based on their domain knowledge. So, accessing quality human resources from the open market and from government is one more USP of this program. Recently, I have gone to Assam. I was so impressed with the quality of the people that are recruited at the state level, district level. block level, bubbling with enthusiasm, all agriculture graduates, veterinary students, and they are doing outstanding work in Sundari, Nagaland. Anybody from Nagaland? Or going to Nagaland? Oh, large number. In fact, next year I promise you, we will have a very big success story from Nagaland. Amazing missions. They are, right now, their Nagaland women are in Kurnool district. And Pakirama is going to go to Nagaland. So please catch up. And you know what we are doing for Nagaland? They are all learning English.
My name is Pakirama. My name is Susan Abram. That name is Wombles. My SAT name is Vasundhara. That 10 members in my group.
So I can assure you, if the Academy invites me next year, we'll have a huge presence from Northeast. We are seeing some very good initiatives from Assam. I was just telling a colleague of yours. So you'll see a lot of them from there. And very good work is happening. They have been able to attract professionals from Nagaland who had gone to Bombay, working in Delhi. So they've been able to tell them, come and make a meaningful difference to your own state. And again, there is no fixed blueprint, there are no guidelines. Each state has to develop its own operational framework. And each year, we hold a 10-day workshop and all the state missions come. They tell us what has worked, what has not worked, and they listen to best practices from across the states, and then they modify their framework. So because we also know that this has to be dynamic, context-specific, so from the national level, I can't trust a particular guideline and say, go according to this. And there are many cases where guidelines are implemented very well, but there's no result on ground. But this is a case where we are saying, you write your own manual while you go along. So this is another strength of this program. And I just want to tell you that we have not started this across all districts, all blocks in one go. The first phase is about 10% of the blocks. And this is driven by the poor themselves. So we are saying, without community resource persons driving the social mobilization, don't do it. So this is a basic difference in the implementation. And Bihar, Odisha and UP, this CRP process has commenced. And right now, we have the women from AP and Bihar are supporting 8 other states, and in 14-15, the balance 14 states, which include all of Northeast, which include Himachal, Uttarakhand, Punjab, so all the states will be covered through this, approach of community resource persons going to these blocks, and when they go, they also identify similar bright spots in the group. Then they train them and they nurture them. So then they are the people who take this. It's like a relay race. Each one, once their life is transformed to some extent, they then become the champions to take it forward. And our idea is that each resource block should support about 20 blocks over a period of 5 years. And that is the model of scaling up that we have adopted. And we're also partnering with some NGOs in Jharkhand, possibly in Gujarat, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, where they have done very good work. Yeah, these 8 states are Jharkhand, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, MP, Rajasthan, Haryana, UP and J&K. I'll skip all this. Yeah, I mentioned this that it is scaled up through the CRPs, and each family is provided support for at least 6 to 8 years. That's where the external mission is there. Otherwise, their own groups continue to support. Like her group is now close to 95, Pachanwe. So 20 years support of the group and their federation. In fact, there was an interaction with the then Joint Secretary to PM, and he asked these ladies, you know, now we have come out of poverty, can we discontinue the program? Then they said, I don't know whether Pajunis or one of them told the JS, ek jamana badalna hai. That means their own children should, you know, be poverty proof. It's not that narrow definition, thoda income bad gaya hai, so people are out of poverty. So they, once they mentioned that, the JS said, yes, this makes sense. But we also don't want the external missionary to be providing this kind of support, because it can also become a parasite. So we would like their own institutions to provide this close hand-holding support. Then this process will happen. These are some of the unique features I already mentioned. It's universal coverage. And this is a program led by women. And they have a very critical role to play at all stages of this program. But also leads to intra-family equity. It's not men versus women. It's a program led by the women, but it promotes intra-family equity. And their own institutions have to provide that long-term hand-holding support. So therefore, when I'm saying their own institutions have to provide the support, so the institutions of the poor then transform to institutions for the poor. So there's no need for an external NGO. Their own institutions then provide this long-term hand-holding support. And there's a need for an exit policy. And in this program, we recognize the multidimensional nature of poverty. That is how the interventions in gender issues, health and nutrition-related issues, insurance. So the multidimensionality of poverty is recognized. And I see this both as a means and end. Building grassroots women leaders is both a means and an end for this program. This also sends an accountability. And as I mentioned, there is no, it's not static, it keeps changing. I just want to repeat what Pajunisa said, that each one of you have an important role to play. Now what is that role is something that you'll have to define for yourself. But this is a program which allows you to contribute in a very positive sense. So I have seen many colleagues, you know, being very cynical about the system, saying that the politicians have not given us any chance, or, you know, I know people of my group saying back in those golden days, you know, we could do whatever we wanted. But that, I think, as you grow old, your memory also becomes very selective. But this is one program where it's entirely up to you. There's nobody who is, because it's an uncharted area. So that's the point I'm making. So it's really up to you. So I just want to end by saying it's a program not only for the poor and of the poor, but it is a program by the poor. And that is what gives it sustainability. And I'll end my presentation here. Just with this thought that I'll repeat from Pajunisa, because there's no better guru in this. She said, poor don't need charity. Poor are capable. How do you unleash their energies? So what is that kind of support which unlocks their energies? And if that is one thought which I can leave behind with all of you, I would think that all of us coming here would be very useful. But I have a lot of hope, because I don't believe, a lot of people tell me, hey, what is this younger generation? They're you know, very cynical, I don't want to repeat that. But I have seen youngsters working in Chhattisgarh, working in Jharkhand, working in Assam. The kind of work each one of you is doing is extraordinary. Now the challenges are also different. So I wish you all the best, and I would require support from each one of you because this task is so big. And there will be a lot of, you know, criticisms, which is most welcome. But nobody else is going to solve the problem. It's a problem of poverty eradication, transformation. Each one has a role. So this is a better, proven model. And I would like sincerely request all of you to support this program to help yourself, you know. So you will be doing yourself a big favor. And I can only say that it's not only empowering others, it's also empowering to yourself. So thank you very much. I would now like our Didi from Bihar. Santi Devi.
जय माता जीविका स्वयं सहायता समूह का कोषाध्यक्ष हूँ। नेहरू जीविका ग्राम संगठन के मैं सदस्य हूँ और संगम जीविका संकुल स्तरीय महिला संघ का सदस्य हूँ और मुजफ्फरपुर जिले से और मुसहरी ब्लॉक से मैं आई हूँ। मैं अपना समूह बनने से पहले मैं अपना बीता हुआ मैं अपना कष्टनाया सुनाता जो मेरे साथ कैसे हमने जीता हुआ कष्ट को हमने सुनाया। हम पढ़े लिखे नहीं हैं, पढ़े लिखे हम नहीं हैं तो हम मेरे पति पढ़े लिखे हैं लेकिन मैट्रिक पास है लेकिन वो काम करने में बहुत कमजोर है, काम करना नहीं चाहते थे। हमारे घर में बहुत दिक्कत होता था, मेरे घर के खर्चा नहीं चल पाता था और हमारे बच्चे 4 थे लेकिन एक मेरा लड़की 12 साल की थी। जो 12 साल की लड़की थी तो मेरे पास मेरे गार्जियन को कमी के कारण एक तो मैं पढ़ी लिखी भी नहीं थी, जो पढ़े लिखे थे वो कुछ करना नहीं चाहे तो लड़की की तबीयत खराब हो गई। हमारी लड़की एक रुपया और चवन्नी का गोलियां नहीं खाई और हम उसको डॉक्टर के पास नहीं ले गए, मेरी लड़की दम तोड़ दिए। सर मेरे साथ ऐसा घटना हुआ। फिर हमने क्या किया कि सोचे अपने दिमाग में कि इस तरह से हम चलेंगे तो मेरे परिवार छिटा जाएंगे तो हमने अपने दिमाग में कुछ सोचने लगा कि हम पढ़े लिखे नहीं हैं लेकिन कुछ हम कर दिखलाएंगे। क्योंकि मेरे समाज में जैसा हुआ कि हम बैठने लायक नहीं थे, हमारे कोई पूछताछ नहीं करता था और हमारे कोई रिश्तेदार हमारे यहाँ नहीं आते थे और हमारा कोई कुछ कहीं एसोसिएशन होता था या शादी ब्याह जो भी होता पार्टियाँ उसमें हमें बुलाए नहीं जाते। हमारे छोट एक बच्चे थे, एक लड़का है, मेरे पास 2 लड़की हैं तो उस लड़की के कहीं दावत में सब दुनिया चले जाते गांव वाले लेकिन मेरे बच्चे को कोई नहीं पूछता तो बहुत रोता था लेकिन हम उसको इसी तरह समझाते थे, पैसे उसे देते थे कि आपको नहीं पूछा तो कोई बात नहीं बेटे नहीं जाना चाहिए। तो हमने अपना कुछ कर चरखा सीखे और हम मुजफ्फरपुर कनौली में चरखा चलाना शुरू कर दिए। जब चरखा हमने काट करके बच्चों को कपड़ा उपड़ा या अपना बिस्तर वगैरह कुछ पैसे उसे ले करके हम अपना परिस्थिति करने लगे। जब हम कुछ दिन करे तो हमको तबीयत खराब हो गया, वो काम हमसे छूट गया। तो जब छूट गया तो फिर हम ये रेशमी धागा अंडे आते थे बक्से में भर भर के उसको हम काम पकड़ लिए तो उसमें हम अंडे गला करके रेशमी धागा निकालना हम शुरू किए। उसमें हम काम तो ज़्यादा किए, मेहनत ज़्यादा था लेकिन पैसे कम था, उसमें मेरा परिवार नहीं चलता था। हम उसको छोड़ दिए। छोड़ने के बाद में हम पति से अपने बोले कि देखो इस तरह से हमारे घर की रास्ते नहीं चलने वाला है, समय मेरा गिरते होते जा रहा है, कुछ हाथ बटाओ। हम दोनों सब्जी को धंधा करते हैं, तो हम दोनों सब्जी के धंधा करने लगे। जब हम सब्जी को धंधा करते थे तो मेरे पति से ठेला रक्षा नहीं खिंचाता था, तो फिर हम किसी तरह तो ले आते थे, लेकिन जब हम सब्जी को धंधा करते तो कुछ भीड़ ऐसे लग जाते थे, तो मेरे पति वजन में तो ज़्यादा तौलते थे, पैसे कम लेते थे, किसी को से पैसे लेते थे किसी से नहीं लेते थे, और मेरा तो इस तरह से हम कहाँ कहाँ देखते, लेकिन मेरा पूंजी जो है कि टूटता चला गया। तो हमने सोचे कि अब ये काम भी छोड़ना ही पड़ेगा, हम छोड़ दिए काम को। जब हम काम को छोड़ दिए तो हम फिर दिल्ली चले गए, दिल्ली चले गए, वहाँ हम 25 साल हम रहे, तो वहाँ हम इतने काम किए, इतनी मजदूरी किए, इतने तो फैक्ट्रियों में हम काम किए, पेन प्रेस भी चलाए, और वहाँ पर हम इतने हाथ का मेरा काला था कि हम हाथ के मतलब ये स्वेटर वगैरह या शॉल वगैरह बिरासी फरमा पर हम बनाते थे, बहुत तरह से हम मेहनत किए रहते थे क्योंकि मेरा परिवार नहीं छिटा। जब वहाँ हम कुछ दिन रह गए तो यहाँ मेरा जितना जगह जमीन था मेरे भाई बहन ने सारे जमीन अपने नाम पर कब्जा कर लिए, तो हमने सोचा कि यहाँ हम रह जाएंगे तो मेरा सदा जीवन नहीं कटेगा, इसलिए हम सोचे कि नहीं अपना घर भी जाना बहुत ज़रूरत है, मेरा औलाद का जगह नहीं मिलेगा। वहाँ से हम आए तो लड़ाई उड़ाई करके 15 दूर हम अपना जमीन लिए, उसमें मेरा इंदिरावास मिला, उसमें हम अपना घर बनाए, इंदिरावास मिला घर बनाए, तो उसके बाद में ये थोड़ा बहुत ये होती खेती बाड़ी हम अपना करने लगे, 10 कट्ठा जमीन लिए, उसमें हम खेती वेती को काम करने लगे, फसल उपजाने लगे, और उसके बाद हम 2008 में मेरा जीविका में हम जुड़ गए। जब जीविका में हम जुड़े तो उसमें से हम कर्ज पैसे लिए, लोन लिए, उसमें से ले करके हम घर बनाए, और हमको पानी पीने के हम अपना चापा कल करवाए, फिर सिलाई मशीन ले करके हम सिलाई करना शुरू कर दिए, सिलाई किए तो बहुत दिन तक बाल बच्चा को हम अपना परवरिश किए, और उसके बाद जब हम हमारा ये लड़की के शादी किए और बच्चों के हम बोले कि देखो बच्चे तुम लोग को पढ़ाई पीछे चला गया, अपने पढ़ाई को पूरा करो क्योंकि समाज लायक कुछ तो बनो, तो लड़का ने हमारे अपने मेहनत करके मजदूरी करके मेरे लड़का मैट्रिक पास किया, और लड़की ने हमारे वो भी अपना मजदूरी करके मैंने अपने पैसे से वो ब्यूटिशियन की काम करके, और वो लड़की अब इंटर में पढ़ाई करी, फिर हम पैसा समूह से ले करके लड़की के शादी कर दी है, और हमारे लेन देन भी आपसी सहयोग अच्छा था, तो हमारे लेन देन आपसी सहयोग अच्छा था, हम भीओ में काम करना हम अच्छा करने लगे, तो सर लोग बोले कि सीआरपी बनो और तुम जा करके भीओ बनाओ समूह बनाओ, तो हम 2 SCG बनाए, एक बार में एक पहली बार में गए तो 30 हम SCG बनाए, और दोबारा गए तो 50 SCG बनाए, सर बोले कि अब ट्रेनिंग आप दे सकती हैं, तो गांव में पहले अपना घूम करके और दो, तो अपने गांव में हम फ्री में बे पैसे की हम ट्रेनिंग दिए और 2-4 VO भी बना लिए वहाँ, तो सर लोग बोले कि अब तुमको बाहर जाना है। इसी तरह से हम बाहर जब निकले तो 500 समूह को हमने ट्रेनिंग दे करके हम भीओ बनाए, और भीओ बनाए तो हम 44 VO बना दिए, और 44 VO बना दिए वहाँ हम अपने हम बाल बच्चों को लेकर के हम अपना ये फिर भी से हम 10 कट्ठा खेत लिए, तो उसमें हम साल में 3 फसल उपजा लेते हैं, एक बार हम धान को खेती करते हैं, दोबारे में गेहूँ को फसल करते हैं, फिर मूँग वगैरह को फसल कर लेते हैं। मेरे लड़का वो बिजली को काम करता है तो इलेक्ट्रिक वगैरह काम करता है वो, तो लड़का भी कुछ कमा लेता है, 200 वगैरह से उसको कमा लेता है, और साथ साथ अपने पापा को ले लिए तो वो भी कमा लेते हैं, दोनों मिल करके काम करते हैं तो करीब साल में 80,000 रुपया को काम कर लेते हैं, और हम साल में 2-3 बार निकल जाते हैं, तो साल में हम भी अपना 30,000 रुपया हम काम कर लेते हैं, तो 1,10,000 रुपया तक ले हम कमा लेते हैं। और हमारे अभी हमारे भियो में समूह में मेरा 1,54,000 रुपया है, और मेरे भियो में अभी 14,52,000 रुपया है मेरे भियो में, और हम लोग इसी तरह से काम चला रहे हैं। और एक बार हम भी गए भियो बनाने, तो वहाँ पर एक दिन की घर में हम थे, सीएम के घर में, तो हमें पता नहीं था, तो उनकी घर में उनका हस्बैंड को मार दिया था गोली से, और उनको
अच्छा देयर इन बिहार सीएम मींस कम्युनिटी मोबिलाइजर, ओके, बिकॉज़ इवन देयर सीएम वाज वेरी अम्यूज्ड दैट देयर आर सो मेनी सीएम्स इन जीविका।
तो सर मार दिए थे, तो उनको ये पता नहीं था कि क्या हुआ उनको घर में, तो जैसे रात में हमको रख दिया गया, और सुबह में बड़े बड़े क्रिमिनल लोग आए थे, मोटरसाइकिल पूरे दौड़ाने लगे, घुमाने लगे कि कैसे सीआरपी है, कैसे सीआरपी है, अरे उसको बुलाओ यहाँ पर, उससे हम थोड़ा बात करेंगे। तो जो मेरे साथ टीम दिया गया था, चार दीदी का था, तो तीन दीदी वो देखी और झट से छुप गई। हमको कहे कि देखो दीदी, ये बड़े बड़े बंदूक लेकर के क्रिमिनल लोग आए हुए हैं, अरे बाप रे पता नहीं क्या होगा, क्या होगा, कुछ नहीं होगा, हम लोग जीविका से आए हुए हैं, इसमें डरने की क्या बात है, अरे हम लोग को तो भेजा गया, हम लोग ऐसा बात थोड़ी है कि हम लोग डरेंगे, हम लोग ढीट होकर काम करेंगे, क्या उनसे बातें कर लेते हैं, क्या पूछना चाह रहे हैं, आप लोग शांत रहिए और हम बात करते हैं। हम निकले, हमको नमस्कार किए, नमस्कार भैया क्या बात है, तो अरे आप कहाँ से आए हैं, हम के लिए हम मुसहरी ब्लॉक से आए हैं, किस काम के लिए आए, हम के लिए हम जीविका प्रेरण से आए हैं। तो दीदी लोग को हम लोग गठन करते हैं और बताते हैं कि वीडियो कैसे बनता है, और छोटे छोटे समूह तो दीदी बना के जुड़ा के चले गए, तो छोटे समूह से छोटा छोटा समस्या का हेल्प होता है, लेकिन बड़ा समस्या के लिए दीदी क्या कीजिएगा, तो इसको बड़ा गठन करना होता है, तो दीदी को हम नहीं बताएंगे, उसमें कमिटी नहीं चुनेंगे, तो दीदी क्या कर पाएगी, वही 10 रुपया बचत करेगी, तो छोटे छोटे समस्या का हेल्प पड़ेगी, बड़ा नहीं कर पाएगी, तो उनको हम लोग बताते हैं, समझाते हैं, गठन करते हैं, तो कैसे बताते हो, कैसे सीआरपी हो, हम कहे कि सीआरपी हम लोग को इसी तरह बोल करके भेजा जाता है, लेकिन सीआरपी हम लोग का ड्रेस क्या आपका प्रूफ है, कि मेरा ड्रेस है, आई प्रूफ नहीं है, तो बोला कैसा ड्रेस है, तो ड्रेस तो मेरा यही था, यही हरा रंग का ड्रेस था, तो यही पहने थे, तो बोला कि इससे हम नहीं मानेंगे, आपको बताना होगा, हम कहे क्या बताना होगा, तो हम नंबर देते हैं, आप बात कर लीजिए जो सर लोग से, सर के नंबर बोले कि नहीं आपको बताना होगा कि कैसे सीआरपी है, आपके पास कोई गन नहीं है, बंदूक नहीं है, सीआरपी हम बोले मेरे पास गंध नहीं है, बंदूक नहीं है, वो ठीक है, हम वो सब लेकर के नहीं चलते हैं, वो लेके चलेंगे तो मेरे दीदी सारे डर जाएंगे, हम इसलिए हम वो लेके नहीं चलते हैं, लेकिन हम वो तो गंध बंदूक लेके चलते हैं जो अपने देश को रक्षा करते हैं, और हमको देश को रक्षा नहीं करना है, हम लोग को तो आगे बढ़ना है, दीदी लोग के ज्ञान बताना है, ज्ञान बांटना है। तो हमारे दीदी कैसे, जो हमारे निपट दीदी है, गरीब दीदी है, जो अपने समस्या से उलझन में पड़ी वो दीदी हमारी कैसे आगे निकल पाएगी, कैसे बढ़ पाएगी और कैसे काम करेगी, और अपना आगे मुँह में बढ़ने की उनको उम्मीद बताते हैं। तो बोले ठीक है, नहीं फिर हम नहीं समझे, फिर अच्छे तरह से हमें समझाओ, क्योंकि हम ये है कमिटी रिसोर्स पर्सन समुदाय साधन से, बोला अच्छा ये है तुम, ठीक है, तो चले गए। हम अपना पहले तो हम कुछ नहीं जानते थे कि पता नहीं हम ऐसे बोल पाएंगे कि नहीं बोल पाएंगे, लेकिन अभी समूह में हमें जुड़ने की देखिए कि हमारा कितना बोलने का झिझक टूटा और मेरा बोलने का अभ्यास हुआ, और हम ये नहीं जानते थे कि ऐसे स्टेज पर हम बात करेंगे और इतने मतलब भाई बहनों से लोग से मेरा मुलाकात होगा, लेकिन आपको देखिए कि आज हम यहाँ पर आकर के आपको बीच हम दो बात भी बोल रहे हैं, और हम नहीं जानते थे कि हमारा ऐसा कोई अमान सम्मान मिलेगा, इज्जत मिलेगा, और बहुत मेरा इज्जत भी मिला, मेरा अमान सम्मान मिला, और ऐसा गरीबों का कहीं मेज और स्थान नहीं था, वो भी हमने अपनाया, और आगे भी हम बढ़ना चाहते हैं, और आप लोग हमें सहयोग दें कि आगे बढ़ करके तो हम भी अब कुछ करें।
धन्यवाद। जिनको मालूम नहीं है कि ये सीआरपी जो है वो सीआरपी से बहुत पावरफुल है. सो वी हैव अबाउट 5-10 मिनट्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स बिफोर वी गो फॉर द सेकंड ब्रेक. आई हैव टोल्ड अबाउट दिस ब्रेक 55 मिनट्स. सो इफ देयर आर एनी questions on whatever you've heard. Also, I would like to tell you, in the afternoon, we are breaking up into quarter groups, and our CRPs will be present in great force in each of these halls, and that's devoted to the Q&A. So that, you know, that is one opportunity. And then I would also like to, you know, suggest if those who are interested, people from Jharkhand, for instance, or J&K, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, and Andhra Pradesh, would like to interact with them sometime in the evening. So that's also feasible. So that is, you know, voluntary. So you can perhaps tell Venkat. I realize Venkat is not a South Indian. Yeah. So what do we do? Are there any questions which can't wait? Yes? Yeah.
Good morning, sir. Raghu Shankar, sir. I have a very simple question, sir. We have heard a lot of success stories, sir. But also learned to, I would like to know from your own words, like, are there any challenges or negative pitfalls in implementation of this program? So that would help us better in the future. Thank you, sir.
I thought you were asking a simple question. Okay. See, I'm standing in front of you after making so many mistakes, after so many failures. It doesn't happen just like that. There will be mistakes, there will be failures. And it's, nothing is foolproof. You have to go through the pain, but definitely based on, I want to answer this question. Based on the experience, what I can definitely say is that we can tell the newer states what not to do, what to do and what not to do. But they are free to make new mistakes. Otherwise, you won't learn. And they are also free to repeat our mistakes. I remember many state missions when I used to advise them that, look, this won't work. But they said, no, no, sir, we want to try. So sometimes I realize that, you know, you don't learn from seeing other people's hands being burned. You have to burn your own hands. It's a very inefficient way of doing it, but that's human nature. For those who are smart, okay, I'll not do that. I'll do something else. But we welcome failures because you learn a lot. One of my biggest failures was our initial assumption that we need a lot of professionals to do this work. But it is Sajanis and others who opened my eyes, said that there has to be a different model. And that is how the newer states will have maybe around 1/4 or 1/5 of the staffing we had in Andhra Pradesh. And that for me is a very big lesson which came out of our own failure. There are numerous, and there will be lots of failures. But definitely what I can tell you is that if you keep something simple, if you keep something which can be done by the poorest person, then you can be sure that that particular model will work. Now what is difficult is how do you make it simple? And that is where your ego comes in the way. All our accumulated learning, and we are all supposed to be great people, we don't make mistakes, and all our subordinates will keep telling us that, sir, you are the greatest officer who has ever been there. So these are all the, you know, sort of hurdles for us. But if you keep it simple, then definitely it will work. So you have seen today, you know, when we started the program in Bihar, we never realized that it will work. But it worked. And the latest is JNK. You said, can't work. In 2004-05, the people used to tell us, theek hai, South India mein chalega, north mein karke dikhao. So then, when we did UP and Bihar, then they said, achha bhi, Jammu mein karke dikhao. So there is some simple truth in all this, whatever we are doing, which enables it to work. So keeping it simple is the most difficult part, and that's where we will fail. But you know, if you succeed more often than you fail, then you are doing fine. But you shouldn't be worried about failing. There will be challenges. But then, collectively, we have you know, a lot of experience gained over the years. So it will help us at least not to repeat very elementary mistakes. Take a repeat some other mistakes, fine. But at least the fundamentals should not be fundamental mistakes should not be made, and we have got collectively a lot of experience. For your question, in fact, Yogita is going to make a presentation on how the, you know, they started work in JNK, and Manik Raj will say what is the plan for that state. So similarly, we have mentored each state mission. So Assam mission is very clear what they need to do, which year. So there is a template, but which you keep revising based on your own experience. So we don't know, after 1 year, something may have worked very fast. So therefore, you don't need to you can change your mind. So that is number one. Number two, you said which one should come first. So therefore, I think again based on our experience, sequencing is very important. Without building a strong foundation, if you try to put too many interventions there, it will collapse. So typically we have seen after the institutions are built, they have to build their own banks, that federations, financial intermediation, that is very, very essential. And that is going to be the lifeline for these members, because we can't depend upon the commercial banks to be that proactive. So this is very important, and focus on their livelihood. As the first, because that's what is bothering them throughout the day. So if we have solutions for that, and that's where the agriculture intervention that I'm talking about, and where we have cracked this, which is a low cost and low risk agriculture model. So agriculture livelihoods are very important, and you will realize that it's a process of dialogue. You know, there's no particular formula. It depends on what is, for instance, Yogita is a doctor. So she felt there should be some health intervention, there should be some early childhood education intervention. So it's not that everything will come from the community only. It's a process of dialogue. So there is something which you feel is important, something they feel is important, then the priorities emerge. Let it flow, it will happen. It is, 2000, when we started the river, felt we could address the issue of low birth weight of children. And today Sudharatna will tell you how in their village, absolutely no low birth weight child. All children are born healthy, there is no maternal mortality rate, and these are all things that they have done by themselves. So these interventions in Rio, there is no particular formula. At least first 2-3 years will go in building institutions, the financial intermediation, financial services provisioning, and then there could be other opportunistic interventions. I have seen in Assam that one of the DMs has linked this to a dairy program. So he was very interested in that, and it made sense. And that's where some mistakes also get made, it doesn't matter. So there's no more problem. Your issue about parallel programs, we are actually advising the states that, forming SHGs for, let us say, promoting heart